Here's How I Like to Play, Nothing Compares to You, cover done by Chris Cornell. If you haven't seen the video, go check it out. It's really great. Also, a buddy of mine who sings, we also did this. So when you want to come go back to the lesson, if it's helpful for you, and you kind of want to see it all put together, I'll put a link to our video so you can kind of see just doing it with acoustic guitar only, opposed to the way that Chris Cornell did with, you know, had several other musicians playing with him. But anyway, great song. All right, so to get started, I guess we'll just kind of go through the verse, and then I'll show you the chorus. There's a couple variations on the verses and the choruses, but it's pretty straightforward all the way through. Not anything really difficult, but just kind of getting that strumming down. If you watch the video, the live video, there's a lot going on in that video, but when you just play with acoustic guitar, I felt it kind of important to kind of get that, you know, the strums and the single notes together and try to, you know, kind of come up with it. Be too hard to kind of explain it, but, you know, I can show it. Again, it's not that hard, it's just getting used to it. Doing the back and forth with the high and low strings, and I think it's just kind of critical to the groove of the song with just acoustic guitar. So the verse is C, and then it's G over B, which is basically a G chord. Just lift your middle finger, and then you just play those five strings, bottom five strings, high five strings, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then we're gonna go into A minor, which is actually a C, with just taking that finger off. And again, we're gonna hit those five strings. So, C, G over B, D minor 7. And then when we get back to C, we're gonna hit C. So, strum C. And then we're gonna go to the second fret on the fourth string. And then we're gonna go to the same string, but on the third fret. And then we're gonna hit open on the third string. And then head back to G. And so basically, I do that 6 times. The vocals come in on the third time. So there's 4 total with the vocals. That progression. And then for the first chorus, it's just gonna do A sharp. It's just, you know, you could do it the proper way and add that E string in there, or, you know, the way that I do it is just the first fret on the fifth string, and then we go to the fourth string on the third on second, third, and fourth string. So, and then we're just going to go to F. So it's first chorus. Again, it's just, then we're gonna get right back to that verse. We'll do it the first time. This is normal. Second time, we're gonna change it up a little bit. Thank you. into the chorus, but this time we're going to do it a little bit different. Start off the same way as we did the first chorus. And now we're going to add an A minor. Here's kind of where the solo starts, and I have a solo piece in there, but it just kind of sounded weak with adding the first part of the solo. So what I decided to do was just for the first measure, the beginning of that solo, is just strum that. So I'll do the kind of walk you through the solo in the end, but I just want to show you that's kind of how that progresses into that section. And so after the solo, then we're going to go back into verse. We're going to do this two times. The song. All right, so the solo starts right after the second chorus, and again, I don't solo through the first part of that. So we're kind of in the first part. And you can just strum it if you want, or whatever. I like to add a little bit of color on the high strings, just to tension in there. And all I'm doing is just, you know, holding an E and just back and forth from the first, second, third string. Just start off with that A sharp, strum it once, so then we're just going to slide up on the 5th string from 3rd fret to the 5th fret, and then we're just going to hit the 4th string on 3rd fret, 3rd string on the 3rd fret. And this is just going to be a little walk down all here on the 3rd string from the 5th fret, 5th, 4th, 3rd, 2nd. So, and now we're going to the 4th string on 3rd fret, so, now we're going to go from 1st fret on the 2nd string, 2nd fret on the 3rd string, and then 3rd fret on the 4th string, so this is what we got so far. Thank you. that string that we ended with. So down to the second fret on fourth string. And then we're going to go to the third fret, fifth string. So third fret, fourth string, fourth string, second fret, and then we're going to go up to the fifth string on the third fret, same string, we're going to hit the second fret. And then we're going to open the fifth string. A minor seventh. So you're gonna hit the second fret, fourth string, and then I like the strum. So strum, then go to the G, and then you're gonna just walk down third fret. Sixth string, second fret, sixth string, open sixth string. So now after you did that open, now we're gonna get the E minor. Just hit the sixth string, the fifth string, give it a strum. This is what we got so far. First fret, second string, second fret, third string, and we're going to hit those together and just slide it up and back. So it's just we're going to slide that up two, and then come back to it, and then we're going to hit open on the third string, and then we're going to hit the second fret on the fourth string. We're going to hit that open, and then we're going to hit the same fret, second fret on the fifth string. Hit that open as well, and then we hit open E, and then go to our G. So here's what we got so far. Fret, sixth string, and we're going to hit the open string on the fourth string, or third, yeah, fourth. Open on that, and then back to it. So, third fret, sixth string, fourth, third open, back to the fourth open, end with the high, your first string. So here's everything. All right, well, hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.